Due to its very wide amount of movement, the shoulder can be one of the hardest areas to model, rig, and animate. There really isn't a single solution or magic button that will result in clean, nice-looking deformation around the shoulder area for every extreme position. Instead, it's a factor of everything: the mesh topology, bone placement and configuration, various weight painting, and modifiers. So let's have a look at each component and how it all comes together. Starting with a topology, the shoulder has a couple of main loops. First are those that form a circle around the shoulder and upper arm. Notice how they are all fairly evenly spaced out, unlike, say, the elbow. This is because the shoulder area can rotate in such a wide range that much of the mesh can both stretch and compress in any given direction. Next, we have the main shoulder loops that form the collarbone and muscles along the top of the shoulder. These mostly intersect with all of the circular loops around the shoulder and upper arm. Finally, there's a loop around the back, which helps to define the shoulder blade. Given that all these loops cross each other, a number of five-point poles are introduced. Starting with a default Rigify Meta Rig that has been roughly scaled to match the character mesh, let's look at bone placement. First is the main shoulder bone, and notice how it starts very much near the spine. If you have it much closer to the arm, that is likely to result in a more pinched deformation, which will just look bad. Also note that by default, the start of the shoulder bone is way more in front of the spine, hence putting any rotation and deformation more towards the chest. And finally, the shoulder and upper arm are separated, resulting in a movement gap between the two. Now, here is an adjusted meta rig where the shoulder bone still sits very much towards the center of the body. However, it is also now moved back into the body, almost in line with the spine and neck bones. Also, the tail of the shoulder bone and the head of the forearm bone are snapped on top of each other, since usually both would move together as a single ball and socket joint. Along with the standard bones, a couple of extra bones have been added for the pectoral muscles and shoulder blades. These provide both automatic deformation in the mesh and custom controls for any adjustment to the form or shape around the shoulder. They are both set up the same, with a main deform bone that then has a tweak control bone at the head and tail. At one end, the deform bone is directly parented to the control, while at the other, a stretch to constraint is used to force the tail of the deform bone to follow the movement of the other tweak control. It is these control bones that are then parented to the main shoulder or arm bone, so that when they are moved, the main deform bone will squash and stretch to follow the movement. Much like most of the deform bones in the generated Rigify rig, these custom bones are also bendy bones. This allows for smoother motion and deformation as the weight painting gets spread out along all the segments of a bendy bone. On the subject of weight painting, initially just automatic weights would be applied. Then, as part of pose testing, various manual adjustments would be done to try and get the deformation looking as good as possible. It is here that the additional bones really start to stand out, especially the shoulder blade. Without it, the whole area would otherwise be weight painted to the nearest spine bones along with the main shoulder bone. Not only would this have resulted in less smooth deformation, but would remove the ability to tweak just the shoulder blade area independently of the top of the shoulder and the spine. However, that's not the end of it. There are also additional modifiers which are needed for volume and smoothing. With both preserved volume and corrective smoothing turned off, things don't exactly look right. Only turning on the preserve volume option doesn't have a huge impact depending on the pose. Yet the corrective smooth modifier does result in a significant difference to the overall form and shape. It is one of the key components in getting good final mesh deformation. It should be noted, however, that in both cases, additional weight painting groups are used to control both the location and strength of each modifier. Preserve volume is more weighted in very specific and focused areas, while corrective smooth tends to be a bit more broad and smoothed out. In each case, one needs to perform various pose testing and work on just a single modifier at a time in order to produce the best deformation result possible. As you can see, there is no single solution or magic button that will produce good deformation. But once you put all of the above together, it is possible to achieve some very nice looking movement. So make sure to subscribe and hit like so you don't miss out on the next character creation installment, and I hope to see you then. Cheers.